So glad to see all of you here today for this concert series concert featuring Jordan Smith. Just a little bit, I'm Reverend Denise Stanford. I'm the pastor of this church for a few more weeks. After that, I'm moving to Boston. So I'm really glad to be here for this and to be able to welcome you. This is one in a series of concerts that we're holding in memory of Sarah and Harry Huber. Harry Huber was a longtime musician here, a fabulous organist, and so it's only fitting that we have a fabulous organist to come play in his memory. So Jordan is an organist and director of music at St. Stephen. In addition to planning and coordinating music for worship at St. Stephen, Jordan leads the adult and children's choirs, serves as organist for three weekly services, and is director of the church's concert series. Jordan holds a Bachelor of Music Education degree from Bethany College in Lindsberg, and a Master of Sacred Music degree from Perkins School of Theology at Southern Methodist University in Dallas, Texas. And he is a former organist here. So would you welcome Jordan and enjoy the concert.
Thank you. Thank you so much, and thank you so much for being here this afternoon. I really appreciate it. And thanks so much to University Church for inviting me back to perform here. It's always great to come home and play. Just a little bit about the piece I just played. That's a theme and variation. So we had a big, huge introduction, and then we heard the theme and a couple of variations on it. And the last one was, that's my workout for the week. Up next, we can't have an organ concert without having Bach, although you can, but the organists don't like that, so they want to hear some Bach, probably. And so this is one of Bach's many chorales from the Orgelbuch line, which is just, the tune is very slow against a nice rhythm that decorates this chorale. And so, Schmücke dich, o liebe Seele, is soul, adorn yourself with gladness. play two piece. These two pieces are by one of my new favorite composers, Andy Lloyd, who lives, he was in the Dallas area for a little while, and then moved down to San Antonio to teach, I believe. But he has composed some absolutely beautiful music for choir and organ, and choir a cappella and organ solo. It's just unbelievable. So if you have time later today and you want to hear some more organ music, just go YouTube Andy Lloyd, and it's some great stuff. So I'm going to play Kingsfold first, and here's a tune to go along in. Kingsfold is the hymn tune to several different hymns in the Methodist hymnal, but sometimes it's better known with O Sing a Song of Bethlehem, or My Soul Cries Out with a Joyful Shout. And then Herzlichen Verlangen is the tune to O Sacred Head Now Wounded, which we know very well in this area, especially because of the St. Matthew Passion that's performed every year in Lindsberg. So please enjoy Kingsfold and Herzlichen. Thank you. great music. And this, I thought I'd pick some softer pieces to really show off the nice soft colors that this organ has. This organ was built in 1917, a time where everything in the world was quieter. Outside was quieter, when you went to a store it was quieter, and when you came to church it was quieter. So organs were built to be a little bit quieter than that. And so this organ has many soft, nice flute sounds, and especially the aria shows off one of the nice harmonic flutes that this organ has. The next piece, Toccata Amazing Grace, is it was written for the dedication, or the 30th anniversary of the Hazel Wright organ at the Crystal Cathedral in Gardner, California. How many of you have ever watched The Hour of Power with Robert Schuller? And so if you've ever watched that, you've probably seen this organ, you've probably heard it. And so this toccata was written for this instrument. And so here is the toccata on Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
It's this very nice dark English music, which this organ has this nice dark soft sound, and you pull out English music really, really well. And so River House was of course a British composer and composed lots of music for the organ, and these three rhapsodies were composed in about 1916. Here's Rhapsody number 1 in D flat.
Thank you.
was fast, for me anyway. I just want to thank you all again for being here. It's good to be back at University of Church. Back when I was here, this place was covered in like orange carpet, and it looks totally different. And it, not only does it look so much nicer, it sounds a lot nicer. And a lot of people say the most important stop on the organ is the room, and the room has been very much improved, which is very important for the organ, so it sounds great. Nice job, everybody here. The last piece is Caroline of Westminster, written by Louis Vierne. Louis Vierne was the organist at Notre Dame Cathedral, and he actually died at the organ. I'll try not to do that today. But he died during a concert that he was giving at Notre Dame Cathedral. And this piece was composed based on the Westminster Caroline, and I'm sure that you'll recognize the theme. I look forward to greeting you afterward for the reception.